Bro, what is this? Does this game think I'm a math professor or something? Okay. What is 8 minus 4? Well, if we really think about this, if we're subtracting 4 from 8, we're literally taking away the 4 from the 8. So I think the answer is just 8. Let me put that here and let's see what our result is. Bro! Alright, let's think about my life choices for a minute. Okay, but anyways. What we just saw was a question that the game gave to us, which was a math problem, and we were able to answer this question by inputting a number inside of a little box, and whatever answer we put inside of that box, we clicked on the submit button to check whether the answer was correct or not. And the way we were able to get this user input from the player was from a new GUI element called a text box, which is the GUI element that I will be introducing inside of this episode so that we can get user input from the player through our GUI elements. And in order to create a text box, we're of course going to need to put this inside of a screen GUI. So we're gonna go to the right side of the Explorer, hit the plus sign next to start GUI, and we're going to insert a screen GUI. We're gonna call this main GUI, and then we're gonna hit the plus sign here, and we're going to insert a text box. So this is what our text box should look like, and we're able to drag this around like normal, but you might notice that we can actually select this text box inside of our studio, and right now it's selected, or focused in this case. So this indicates that we're able to type something inside of this text box. So if I literally type in hello, or just anything really, then it's going to change the text of this text box to whatever I just typed in. We can delete this, and we can even deselect it so we can unfocus from it to where it's just now a blank text box. And like I mentioned, we can just select it again so that we can focus on it, and we can put in, a new text here, like, how are you doing? And this is the cool thing about a text box, is that it's kind of like a text label, but if it was able to be changed by the user when they're playing the game. That's kind of like an easy explanation I can give to text boxes and how they are used inside of the game. So that was just something I wanted you to understand a little bit. And I mentioned that when we select our text box, we go into this focus mode. This is just called focusing on the text box. And if we're not focusing from it anymore, that's just called defocusing. So those are just two terminologies that I want you to get a grasp at, because there's going to be properties and events and functions that we're going to use that require you to know the difference between focusing and defocusing. It's pretty easy, so I think you pretty much get the basic understanding of that. What I'm gonna do now is introduce you to a bunch of properties that are specifically used for text boxes. But before we do that, let's make some changes to our text box. So let's select this text box and let's just put in some sort of text here. Let's say Roblox is amazing. Now what we'll do is select our text box and let's scroll down to the text category and let's make text scaled turned on and let's scale this so we can see it a lot easier. And let's also reposition this to the center, and I realize I'm gonna have to type that again. That's fine, so we'll just go to the text label here and say, Roblox is awesome. All right, so now that we have that, let's scroll back up in the properties tab. So the first property that I want to introduce that's unique to text boxes is called ClearTextOnFocus. And basically what this means is that when you focus on the text box that already has text on it, it's just going to wipe away whatever text was originally on this text box so that you can put in some new text inside of here. So we can just say Roblox sucks instead. In order to prevent this to where we defocus and focus back on it again, we don't want it to just delete all the previous text that was there. What we can do is turn off clear text on focus. So let's uncheck this. And let's type in our original message. Let's say Roblox is awesome. Let's deselect it and then select it again. And as you can see, the text box did not wipe whatever text originally was in here. So we could just continue off what we were trying to say with this text box prior. So we could just replace awesome with Roblox is bad. There's also another property called MultiLine, and basically what this means is that when you have this turned on, you can create text that have multiple lines inside of the same text box. So if I hit enter, which drops down to the next line, we're able to do this and we can just write text line by line. So we can say, nah, Roblox is good. And then we can just drop another line down here and then we can say, meh, I'm not sure. And so we can just keep doing this over and over again. But if we disable multi-line and we try to drop down to the next line, it's not going to work. If we just hit enter, then it just simply deselects the text box. We also have text editable, which basically means if we have this turned on, then whenever our player is playing inside of the game, then we can select this current text label and update the text however we want it to. But if we have it turned off, let's turn off text editable, then the player will not be able to add any more text to it. As you can see, I'm trying to type on my keyboard right now and nothing is being put onto this text box because I disabled text editable. So this is useful during the game when there's going to be certain periods where you just don't want the player to edit whatever is currently in the text. So I'd say that's pretty much the only time I would find text editable to be useful, but I think that's just something good to know. If we scroll down, there are new properties related to the text category. So first thing, we have this thing called a placeholder text. And pretty much what this means is that if there is no actual text on this text box, then Roblox is going to put in a text for you before the player actually does put a text inside of this text box. So it's kind of like a default text before putting an actual text in there. So let me show you what this looks like. Let's delete our text here. And as you can see, there's no text inside of our text box, but it's kind of hard to tell that this is a text box other than our cursor change. So one really neat way we can let the player know that this is a text box is by adding in a placeholder text. So let's change this, for instance, to enter your answer here, dot, dot, dot. So Roblox is going to put in a default text here if you don't already have text here. So if we select this, then we can put in text inside of this text box, and the placeholder text will automatically go away, being replaced by the text we just put in. And if we leave the text property empty again, then it'll just go back to the placeholder text. So I'd say this is pretty neat to let the player know that this is supposed to be a text box that the player is supposed to input information into here. And so that's pretty cool to know about. Another thing related to placeholder text is placeholder color 3. So by default, it's this sort of grayish text color, but if we click on this square color, then we have a panel where we can choose whatever color we want. I don't know, dark green or something. We can hit okay. And this is going to be our placeholder text, but our actual text is going to be whatever our text color 3 is. And that's pretty much the general gist of it. So now I want to introduce the scripting components of this text box. And first we'll start with two events. The first one being focused and the other one being focused lost. So let's just insert a local script inside of our text box over here. Let's hit the plus sign, hit local script, let's delete this. And we will make reference to our text box by saying local text box equals script.parent. And down here, we're going to create our first event. We're going to say text box.focused colon connect function, open parentheses, close parentheses, hit enter. So this event is basically going to fire whenever the player selects the text before they input any sort of information onto this text box. So let's just do something simple by writing a print statement by saying print player has selected the text box. And we can basically do the same thing when they go out of focus from this text box, also known as deselecting the text box. We can say textbox.focusLost colon connect function. So let's hit enter and let's write a print statement here by saying player has lost focus of the text box. So these are the two events that'll simply activate whenever first the player selects the text box, and then this will fire when the player defocuses from the text box. So let's test this out really quick. All right, so I'm in the game. When I focus on this text box, it's now saying in the output, player has selected the text box. We can put in some random information here, and if we deselect it, then it's going to say player has lost focus of the text box. And what's also interesting about defocusing is that if we select our text box again, as long as we stay focused, it's only going to print player has selected the text box one time. It's not going to happen every time we click on this while we're still focusing on this text box. However, instead of just clicking away from this text box in order to deselect it, we can also hit enter, and this will also activate the focus lost event by saying player has lost focus of the text box. And I believe this also works by hitting escape as well. So there are definitely a bunch of keys that act as losing focus of the text box, like hitting enter or pressing escape or clicking outside of the text box. So those are just stuff that you probably should be aware of when you're trying to design your text boxes for your Roblox game. So going back to focus lost, there are two arguments here, but the only one that's really important here is enter pressed. Input that caused focus loss doesn't really matter all too much, at least compared to enter pressed. So our first argument is going to be enter pressed, and this is the one we're interested in. Enter pressed is basically a Boolean that tells us whether the player lost focus from this text box if they hit enter and not do anything else, whether that was clicking away from the text box or hitting escape. So let's make that check down here by saying if enter pressed, then this just implicitly checks whether the player has pressed enter. Well, let's write a print statement by saying player hit enter to lose focus. So now let's test this. So let's just put some random stuff in here and let's hit enter. We're going to see that not only did it print player has hit enter to lose focus, but it also printed the other thing that was originally here, player has lost focus of the text box. Now, if we select this again and then hit escape, for instance, all it's going to say is player has lost focus of the text box and not because the player has hit enter. So that's something pretty interesting to know about. Let's say this is like a confirmation text box that you're trying to use for your systems. And then finally, we have three functions from the text box that I will be introducing in this episode. So the first function is CaptureFocus, which is basically forcing the player to automatically select this text box during a certain point in the game without the player doing it themselves. So we're going to do that by going to our local script, and let's quickly comment out these print statements so that our output will look a lot nicer when we test whatever it is we're going to test for the rest of the time. So what we're going to do first is after about 5 seconds, we're going to force the player into focusing on the text box. So what we're going to do is drop two lines down here, and we're going to say task.wait, put about 5 seconds there. And then down here, let's say textbox colon capture focus, open parentheses, close parentheses. So this will basically, so after about 5 seconds, the text box will force the player to capturing the text box. And by doing this, it's going to fire this focused event up here so that we can make it do whatever we want it to do. So just for right now, let's actually uncomment this again so that we can see whether this works or not. Let's test this out. So after about 5 seconds, we should automatically be selecting this text box, as you can see with this little blinking line at the very beginning, while also saying here, player has selected the text box. So it's working as expected, and we can deselect it if we wanted to. The next function is called isFocused, and this is basically a getter function that just returns a Boolean as to whether the player is currently focusing on this text box. And it goes something as simple as this. So let's go to our local script, and let's check to see in about 5 seconds whether the player is still focusing on this text box. And we're actually going to do this using a task delay rather than a task wait, because we don't want the script to pause completely if this is the case. So We're going to do this by saying task.delay, open parentheses, close parentheses, and we're going to put in the duration, which is 5 seconds, comma, and we're going to create a new function by saying function, open parentheses, close parentheses, enter. So let's create a new Boolean here by saying local is focused equals text box colon is focused, open parentheses, close parentheses. So this Boolean is going to tell us whether the player is still focusing on this text box after about 5 seconds. So let's make that check by saying if is focused, then what we will do is say print player is still focused on the text box. So that's pretty much how it's going to work for this script right here. So after about 5 seconds, the game is going to automatically make us capture this text box, and it's going to call this focused event. And after about 5 seconds, just by having the script delay for a little bit without actually stopping the script, we're going to see if the player is still focused on the text box. And if it is, then we're going to print this statement right here. So let's go into the game and see our change. All right, so after about 5 seconds, the text label should automatically select the text box for us. But after about another 5 seconds, it then displayed players still focused on the text box, and we haven't made it do anything else yet. We're still focused on this. So this is where the last function comes in. If we don't want this to continuously be selected, we can use a function called ReleaseFocus. So this is what it's going to look like. Let's go to our local script, and after about 5 seconds, if the player is still focused on the text box, let's make the script automatically defocus the player from the text box so that the player doesn't have to do it themselves. So let's drop a line and let's say text box colon release focus, open parentheses, close parentheses. And there you go, just like that. Let's go into the game and see our change. All right, so the text box automatically selected for us. So in about 5 seconds, what should happen is that the script will automatically deselect this text box as shown right here. So the script pretty much works as intended. But there also is an additional parameter to this release focus function called submitted. And we can basically add in a Boolean here of either true or false. And pretty much this submitted argument tells us whether we want to override the enter pressed parameter inside of focus lost. Because as you know, as soon as we release our focus, then focus lost is automatically going to fire. So we don't want enter pressed to be fired if we choose not to. So what we can do is pass in a argument of Boolean true for submitted so that we can override this enter pressed parameter, and we don't need to check for enter press because we already know that this submitted parameter is true. I hope that makes a little bit of sense. So that's pretty much the basics of text boxes. I'm clearly not cut out to do math problems, so I need to reevaluate my life choices after this video is over. But I hope you learned something new from this episode. Be sure to join my Discord server. The link is in the description, and I will see you in the next episode. Take care.